Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. Hope you all are enjoying learning with Easy Dentistry. If you like our lectures, please turn on the thumbs up icon and turn it blue. If you understand our lectures, I request you all to subscribe to our channel. And if you want more of such knowledge filled lectures, do comment below and tell us. So today's lecture is on a very important topic we are starting today, that is the antimicrobial drugs. This is a very important question which is asked frequently in exams, and also students, you have to be thorough with your antimicrobial drugs when you practice dentistry in your clinic. So let's start today's topic. In this lecture, we will be studying first what are the antimicrobial agents, and then we will be studying the various classification systems of the antimicrobial agents. Now, the introduction. Antibiotics are the drugs that cure rather than palliate diseases. These are the most frequently used drugs and also the most misused drugs. So you should have a thorough knowledge of antimicrobial agents to prevent the misuse of these drugs. Now, antibiotics are designed to inhibit or kill the infecting microorganism and have no or minimal effect on the recipient. So it should kill the microorganism and have no effect on the recipient. So this property of the antimicrobial agent make it different from other drugs. Now this type of therapy is also called as chemotherapy. It is called chemotherapy because it is a treatment of the systemic infections with specific drugs, and these drugs selectively suppress infecting microorganisms without affecting the host. So it is called as the chemotherapy. Now, what causes selective microbial toxicity? Why these antimicrobial agents are selectively toxic to the microorganisms and they are non-toxic to the patient's body? What make it so? This is due to the action of drug on the components of the microbe. For example, some drugs may have an action on the cell wall of the microbe, or some drugs have action on the metabolic processes of the microorganisms, for example, folate synthesis. These are the processes which are present only in the microbes and not in the host. These antimicrobial agents have high affinity to the microbial biomolecules, and this makes them microbial selective toxic drug. Now, what are antibiotics? Antibiotics are the substances produced by microorganisms, and these substances selectively suppress the growth or kill other microorganisms at a very low concentration. Now, this low concentration is important. Now, the antimicrobial agents, or the AMA. What are these AMA? These are synthetic as well as natural drugs that kill the microorganisms. Both the synthetic as well as naturally derived drugs are together called as the antimicrobial agents. Now let us study the classification of antimicrobial agents. There are six systems of classification, and these are very interesting. Let us study them in detail. The first basis of classification of the antimicrobial agents is depending upon the chemical structure of the drug. They are divided into 19 different categories. First is the sulfonamide and related drugs, which include sulfadiazines and dapsone and para-aminosalicylic acid, or PAS. Then comes the diaminopyrimidine group, which includes trimethoprim and pyrimethamine. The third category is that of quinolones, which include nalidixic acid, norfloxacin, ciprofloxacin and moxifloxacin. The fourth group is that of beta-lactam antibiotics, which include penicillin, cephalosporin, monobactam and carbapenems. The fifth group is that of tetracycline, which include oxytetracycline and doxycycline. The sixth group is the glycylcycline, which includes TJ cycline. The seventh group is that of nitrobenzene derivative, which includes the chloramphenicol. The eighth group is that of aminoglycosides, which contain drugs like streptomycin, gentamicin and neomycin. Ninth one is macrolide antibiotics, which include erythromycin, clarithromycin and azithromycin. The tenth group is that of lincozamide antibiotics, which include lincomycin and clindamycin. Then comes the polypeptide antibiotics group, which include the polymyxin B, colistine, bacitracin and tyrosine. The 12th group comes of the glycopeptides, which include vancomycin and teicoplanin. 13th group is that of oxazolidinone, which include linezolid. The 14th group is that of nitrofuran derivatives, which include nitrofurantoin and furazolidone. Then is the nitroimidazole group, which include the metronidazole and tinidazole. Then comes the nicotinic acid derivatives, which include isoniazid, pyrazinamide and ethionamide. Then comes the polyene group, which includes nystatin, amphotericin B and hamizine. The 18th group is that of azole derivatives, which include miconazole, clotrimazole, ketoconazole and fluconazole. And the 19th group of classification, depending upon the chemical structure, include the remaining drugs, which include the rifampicin, vincomycin and ethambutol. The second system of classification is depending upon the mechanism of action of the drug. Depending upon the mechanism of action, the first group of antibiotic agents, antimicrobial agents, include those drugs which inhibit the cell wall synthesis, like the penicillin, cephalosporin, cycloserine, vancomycin and bacitracin. The next group contains the drugs which cause leakage of the cell membrane. These are further divided into polypeptides and polyenes. The polypeptides include polymyxin, colistin and bacitracin, while the polyenes include the amphotericin B, nystatin and hamisine. Thirdly, those drugs which inhibit protein synthesis include tetracycline, chloramphenicol, erythromycin, clindamycin and linezolid. Fourth group is the drugs which cause misreading of mRNA code and affect permeability. These include aminoglycosides like streptomycin and gentamicin. Fifth group is that of those drugs which inhibit the DNA gyrase, which include fluoroquinolones and ciprofloxacin. Then sixth is the those which interfere with DNA functions such as rifampicin. Seventh group is that those drugs which interfere with DNA synthesis such as acyclovir and zidovudin. Eighth is that of the drug which interfere with intermediary metabolism, which include sulfonamide, sulfone, para-aminosalicylic acid, trimethoprim and pyrimethamine. Now the third system of classification of the antimicrobial agent is the type of organism against which the drug is primarily active. So, the antibacterial drugs include penicillin, the aminoglycosides erythromycin and fluoroquinolone. The antifungal agents which include greasofluvin, amphotericin B and ketoconazole. Antiviral drugs include acyclovir, amantadine and zidovudine. Antiprotozoal, which include chloroquine, pyrimethidine, metronidazole and diloxanide. And the antihelminthic group, which include mebendazole, pyrantel, niclosamide and diethyl carbamazepine. Now, the fourth basis of classification of the antimicrobial agents is on the spectrum of activity. The drugs are divided into narrow spectrum and the broad spectrum. The narrow spectrum drugs include penicillin G, streptomycin and erythromycin, while the broad spectrum include tetracycline and chloramphenicol. Now, the initial distinction between these narrow and broad spectrum antibiotics is no longer clear cut. However, these terms are still applied in clinical practice. Now, the fifth system of classification is dependent upon the type of action, whether the action is bacteriostatic or bactericidal. So, the primarily bacteriostatic antimicrobial agents are sulfonamides, tetracycline, erythromycin, clindamycin, chloramphenicol and linezolid. While the bactericidal drugs include penicillin, aminoglycosides, polypeptides, rifampin, clotrimoxazole, vancomycin, metronidazole and ciprofloxacin. Now, the last system of classification of the antimicrobial agents depend upon the source from which the antimicrobial agent is derived. If the source is fungus, the drugs which are obtained from fungi are penicillin, greasofluvin and cephalosporin. The drugs obtained from bacteria are polymyxin B, colistin, bacitracin, tyrothrecin and aztreonam. And the drugs derived from actinomycetes include aminoglycosides, tetracycline, chloramphenicol, macrolides and polyenes. So, here we complete with the lecture on the classification system of antimicrobial agent. Next lecture will be an important LAQ question, that is, what are the problems that arise with the use of the antimicrobial agent? In this lecture, we will be considering toxicity, hypersensitivity reaction, drug reactions, superinfection and many other important concepts. So if you don't want to miss the lecture, please subscribe to our channel. Until then, happy studying.